And welcome back. I'm Malin, for those of you who don't know me. And today is going to be a little bit of a different video. Rob and I are just heading out now to have a little staycation in our current hometown of Malmö. Malmö town invited us and is a kind sponsor of this video, so thank you to them. We have some plans for today and this evening, but before we tell you all about them, we want to do a little throwback to the other day when we visited one of our favorite places here in Malmö called Flax. It's a lovely cafe that unfortunately isn't open on the days that we're having our staycation, but we wanted to show you anyway, so check it out. Flax is a pretty awesome place, and one of the reasons we really like it is because the owners are really super friendly and passionate. They have an urban farm here in Malmö, so they grow their own produce, and for the other things that they have on their menu, they source them from local vendors here in Malmö, which we think is really cool. So now we're gonna start our staycation. We're gonna head out and get some snacks for this evening. We're gonna have a late lunch, and then we're gonna head to the hotel, which is one of the fun parts about the staycation. We're gonna stay at Story Hotel here in Malmö. So yeah, come along and we'll show you. To our hotel room here in Malmö, and it has the most amazing view that I'm going to show you in one second. On the way here we went to Gram, which is Malmö's package-free shop, a place that we visit a lot and we like, and we got some snacks for this evening. It's a really cool shop. They have lots of dry goods and also sustainable products that are obviously to replace products you can't use more than once. So there's plenty to look at there. Then we headed to Malmö Saluhall, where we thought we would eat lunch, but between the rain and feeling the need to social distance, we didn't feel like we could stay and eat there because there weren't that many seats available, and it was actually a lot of people there, so we didn't feel comfortable. And that's part of, or something we have to think about throughout the staycation, is that Rob and I still want to social distance. We don't want to put ourselves in a situation where we could contract the virus or spread it, of course. So yeah, we decided to just grab a few nice bits there. We got some vegan cheese and some kombucha that we're instead gonna have here in the room. And we brought some other snacks and treats as well. So we're gonna have a little room picnic. And I think that's a nice thing about a staycation, if you're gonna do it in your town that you live or your city, is to book a really nice hotel room like we have here and enjoy it, because it's part of the experience, right? So that's what we're gonna do. But before, let me show you our hotel room. We've enjoyed our little hotel room picnic. It was really nice, and we've come out for an evening stroll. It stopped raining actually before we ate, but we thought we'd still eat in our room and enjoy the view. And now we're just finishing the day off with a nice walk through Malmö during the sunset. So we'll show you some images from Malmö at night. It's a new day for our Malmö staycation and the sun has come out for us. We're walking through the old town part of Malmö now and we're gonna head to have a little bit of fika. And then we're going to check out Malmö konsthall for some art. Hopefully there are not too many people in there so that we can go in and look around. But if there are, we might just have to change our plans and see what else we can do. Then we're planning to grab some lunch and go have a picnic in the park. So I'm looking forward to show you. Let's go. Right now we're in Slottsträdgården, a really beautiful garden and situated in a lovely park here in Malmö called Slottsparken. It's a really big park where you can have nice walks and this garden is beautiful, full of flowers and bees. And yeah, we thought we would have our lunch here, but when we went to the cafe that we had planned to visit, Farm to Table, it actually was quite quiet and there was space to sit outside. So we decided to actually sit there instead. We had a nice smoothie bowl and a avocado toast with some beetroot hummus. And it's a nice place for like a light lunch or maybe a breakfast. Not like the portions aren't very big, so don't go there too hungry. Otherwise, I would recommend it. And before that, we did manage to go to Konsthallen, and it's a beautiful space, a big room, big bright room with lots of windows and an interesting exhibition as well by a Swiss artist residing here in Malmö now. And before that, we managed to go and have a fika at AB Småland. Again, we felt quite comfortable to sit on their outside seating. So we just had a little fika there, and it's a beautiful shop. If you're in Malmö, you should visit. It's an organic concept store with a cafe. They have clothing and they have beautiful homewares and plants. So if you're interested in those kinds of things, it's definitely a shop for you. But now we're just gonna have a little walk through the park and then head back to the hotel. And then this evening we plan to have a little pizza picnic on the beach. So we'll take you with us there. Last morning from the hotel room. Today is our last staycation day, or actually we're just going to be doing some things this morning, but I wanted to recap a little bit what we did last night. So we picked up some pizza from a place called Fredos, which has really good vegan options. They also have gluten-free bases that taste really good, and we picked pizzas up there and we took them to the Ribersborg beach, which is a nice beach. It's kind of quiet, it had a few people around, and there's also a bar down there and an ice cream little hut. And yeah, we just had our pizza there and we thought we'd watch the sunset, but unfortunately it was really cloudy. This is quite a moody evening, but it's actually really beautiful down there with that gray sky. You can see the bridge to Denmark, you can see the turning torso on the other end, which is the tallest building of the Nordics. So it's a pretty nice spot for a picnic. And I also wanted to say, if you want to have pizza in Malmö, there's another place that does really good vegan pizza called Farihatten, which is located in the Folkets Park, which is a park in another area of Malmö. So I can recommend that. And actually we went there last year when we did a video like this, and I'll link that video down below if you want to check it out. And I also did a blog post with lots of places and tips for coming to Malmö, so I'll link that down below as well. But now we're going to check out of the hotel in just a few minutes, and then we're gonna head to have a last little fika on our staycation, and then go to the market, and then head home to finish off this little mini holiday. Thank you. had a lovely fika at a local bakery here in Malmö called Bageri Leve. They have plenty of vegan options and coffee and tea. And yeah, the sun came out for us, so it was really nice. Then we headed to Möllevångstorget to get some fresh veggies to take home so that we have something to eat for the next few days. It's a lovely, bustling market that's open Monday till Saturday. You can get fresh fruit, fresh veggies, and yeah, it's a really nice atmosphere. And we go there quite often to get our fruit and veg. And the birds are chirping in and our staycation is coming to an end. But before I leave you, I want to say that this has been a great opportunity for us to show off some local businesses here in Malmö and to support them. And I also want to say that I'm aware there's a pandemic going on and this kind of staycation is not suitable for everywhere around the world at the moment. We have taken the safety measures that are sort of outlined by our government, and of course you should follow the recommendations, guidelines, rules that you have in your country. I just hope that you've enjoyed seeing some glimpses of Malmö, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Take care!